A very warm welcome to St. Paul's Cathedral for Choral Evensong on this feast of St. Andrew, Apostle and Martyr. Andrew was a fisherman, and he was one of the first to be called by Jesus to enter into discipleship, to become one of his followers. And he called his brother Peter, and he brought him along with him on the journey of discipleship. He was told that he would be a fisher of people in future. Our cathedral stands on the traditional lands of the Kulin nation, and I'd like to pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging, and to Aboriginal people and Torres Strait Islanders who are engaging with our worship tonight. I'm joined for this service by my colleagues, the lay clerks of the cathedral choir, under the direction of Mr. Philip Nichols, by organist Siegfried Franke, and our director of photography, Andrew Victorson. Wherever you're joining us from for this service, I hope that you will feel at home here at St. Paul's tonight. The choir will sing the psalm for this evening, office Psalm 48, set to music by William Russell.
The Lord's side. He begins the 20th verse of the 8th chapter of the prophecies of Zechariah. Thus says the Lord of hosts, peoples shall yet come, the inhabitants of many cities. The inhabitants of one city shall go to another, saying, come, let us go to entreat the favour of the Lord, and to seek the Lord of hosts. I myself am going. Many peoples and strong nations shall come to seek the Lord of hosts in Jerusalem, and to entreat the favour of the Lord. Thus says the Lord of hosts, in those days 10 men from nations of every language shall take hold of a Jew, grasping his garment and saying, let us go with you, for we have heard that God is with you. Here ends the first lesson.
It begins the 20th verse of the 12th chapter of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Now, among those who went to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor." Here ends the second lesson. I invite you to join with me in confessing the faith of the Church in the word of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ. To bring those near to us into his gracious presence, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Amen.
For mighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God now and forever.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandment, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The choir will sing the anthem, "Give Us the Wings of Faith, to rise within the veil and see the saints above." Words by Isaac Watts, set to music by Ernest Bullock.
Oh,
Let us pray. We pray for the peace of this world, for world leaders and those in responsibility of leadership, for the troubled areas of our world, for places where people find life difficult or dangerous. We pray for the people of Ethiopia. We pray for the people of Belarus, for the people of Thailand, and for the people of the United States of America. And we pray for the land in which Andrew lived, Israel and Palestine. We give thanks for the nations over which Andrew is patron saint, and we remember particularly the people of Greece and Scotland. Almighty God, kindle, we pray, in every heart the true love of peace, and guide with your peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your dominion may increase until the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As Andrew entered into a life of self-giving, loving service, we pray for all those who enter on the road of discipleship, forsaking self and seeking to serve their Lord. We give thanks for all institutions that bear Andrew's name. And we give thanks for his example and ask that we too might serve others as we would be served by Christ. Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son came not to be served, but to serve, bless all who, following in his footsteps, give themselves to the service of others, that with wisdom, patience, and courage, they may minister in his name to the suffering, to the friendless and the needy, for the love of him who laid down his life for us, your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. And we pray for ourselves and for those whom we have come to pray, and we ask that God would protect us and that God would bless us. O Lord, support us all the day long until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in your mercy grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last. Amen. We bless one another in the words of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Please stand, if you're able, in joining to sing the hymn, The God of Abraham Prays.
Thank you.
and to God's gracious mercy and protection we commit you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, now and forevermore. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and those whom you love, wherever they may be, this night and always. Amen.